By the end of this video, you will know how to use the auto grading function in Clo3D to grade multiple sizes for a basic top, easy step by step. We will grade this top from an extra small to a medium size by using the auto grading function in Clo3D. Then, save that graded pattern for the future. Next, we are going to change this avatar size. So we have two options here to change the avatar size to meet a need. Either we come over here to this avatar folder, double click on it, then come down to female underscore V2. Why I select female underscore V2? Because Camilla is the avatar version 2. We want to select the sizes version 2 before the sizes work on this avatar. Okay. So after I select, let's say, okay, I double click on the Emma or Camilla, for example, I can select any sizes from the size folder. Okay. Just click on it. So as you can see right here, these are the size that come with Clo library. You can select any sizes you want right here. Let's say, okay, I want to select this Missy Curvy. Just double click on that size and then I can select either size 6, size 8, size 4. Let's try size 6. Double click on it to apply the size to the avatar. And as you can see, now the size applies onto the avatar because we see the garment kind of shift to in a different direction. However though, the other option that I really like over here, I already have my own custom avatar as well as custom size that I already linked into this library. So I have the link below guide that how to custom your avatar as well as change the avatar size links below under this video description. Okay, so we are going to come back here to my custom avatar size here. I'm going to double click on that folder to open. Then, as you can see, the sizes appear right here from extra small to small to medium, large, and so on. Okay, so now I'm going to apply extra small size onto this avatar. To apply, I can either double click like I did earlier, just like that. Okay, then this is cool function, guys. This right here is called Redrape 3D Arrangement. If I click on that button right there, it will drape that top onto the avatar, just like that, one click. So after we redrape the top onto the avatar, next I'm going to select all these pattern pieces by command or control plus letter A to select all that pattern pieces. Then I'm going to come over here to this object browser and I'm going to select this button right here, guys. This is apply or assign size on to that top, okay? So I'm going to click on it to assign the size. As you can see, these highlighted points appear on to these pattern pieces. Next, I'm going to come down here to this 2D toolbar and select this auto graded icon to bring this auto grading window and maintain pattern curvature. We want that 100%. Let me move over here a little bit so we can see this better. And maintain graphic size. We don't have any graphics on the garment, so we don't have to worry about that. Just leave that unchecked, okay? And this is important. Change particle distance to 20 millimeter to get the most optimized result. And we did that earlier. Now we are going to click on OK to confirm. Okay, now it looks like nothing really happened. However, when I draft this top, I use this XS avatar size to draft the top. Now we are going to grade this top to a size small top. So I'm going to come over here and click on that right there, okay? To assign the next sizes onto this top right here. Then I'm going to come over here, okay? This is important. You must always remember to change the avatar sizes for the auto function grading to know. To do that, once again, I'm going to double click on that size S right here, okay? Okay, so now we have a choice here. You can either click on that 3D arrangement to redrape this pattern, or you don't have to, okay? So I will show you. Just come over here, click on this auto grading one more time, and to bring this auto grading window, once again, maintain pattern curvature to 100% and uncheck the graphic size and click on OK. Okay, so now as you can see right here, we have two sizes, okay? So a top just changes from size XS to size S. Next, we are going to grade it to size M. All right. To do that, just come over here to this object browser, click on this size M right here, okay? And come over here to this asset tab right here. We are going to select size M, okay? So double click on that size to apply the size onto the avatar. All right, I'm going to come over here to this favorite auto grading function, click on it. Then to bring this auto grading window, I'm going to leave everything as is by maintain pattern curvature 100%, uncheck this maintain graphic size, then click on OK to confirm. Okay, so next I'm going to come over here to this 2D window and select the transparency surface so we get to see all the sizes of this top that we just graded from size S to M. And as you can see, if I zoom in closer, we see all these pattern pieces are graded accordingly. Okay, so after we graded this pattern, next I'm going to show you two options to save this pattern. First option, we will save it as a garments file. To do that, I'm going to come over here to file, then select save as, and then hover the mouse to the right and select garment. So this function allows you to edit your pattern later if you wanted to. So I'm going to name it garment. Okay, top 2, and then XS 2M. Then I'm going to save in the same folder here, then click on save. And option number 2, I'm going to export it as a PDF file by come over here to file, then select export and hover the mouse to the right and select export as Adobe PDF. Next, I'm going to name it PDF top 2 underscore XS and then M graded XS to M. I'm going to navigate to the folder and then I'm going to select save. And this will bring up this export PDF window. And you want scale to be millimeter, 100%, do not rotate. Then come over here, I'm going to click on that arrow right there to expand, and we want graphic line, internal line. Basically, just check the show line box right there, just like that, to check all the boxes. And down here, graphic, you want to check start. And pattern annotation, line length, grain line, button and 2D measurement. Then click on OK to confirm. Okay, after that, we are safe to close this close file, just come over here to this X and click on it to close. Okay, so there is the pattern that we exported earlier as a PDF. Thanks so much for watching, Designista. I hope you find this video useful. And remember to sub and click on the bell for more awesome videos. Thank you.